Yo, I'm Saxon with Guy in a Cube. Another week, another roundup. We've got some cool updates, some tips and tricks, all coming at you. If you're gonna be in Atlanta, Georgia next weekend, Patrick and I will be at SQL Saturday Atlanta. We would love to see you, meet you, talk with you, hang out, maybe get a coffee together. Come out, say hi, and let's learn something. I want to do something new and just call out a comment from the previous week and then comment on the comment. And so in last week's roundup, Michaelo Bahir, I apologize if I'm pronouncing your name wrong, I'm horrible with names, asked, hello, could you please recommend some really good DAX courses? The first thing I will point you out to is go to sqlbi.com. They've got amazing DAX courses that can get you up and running and understand how all this works internally in a very structured way. So definitely go check that out. There's also other trainings out there. I'll have some links down in the description below for you. Thanks for asking. Be sure to hit that subscribe button to stay up to date with all the videos from both Patrick and myself. And with that, let's dig in. Lindsay Pinchot's got a blog post looking at how to use dynamic titles inside of Power BI. This is a cool trick, something we've highlighted also on Guy in a Cube, but it is a great way to just add some immersion into the reports and add context to the data that you're looking at. The examples that Lindsay uses is looking at drill through and then taking those items that you drilled through into and putting that in the title of the page that you're looking at. The magic here is using DAX, creating a measure that uses that selected value function, and then you can actually display the text of the title that you want. So if you're not familiar with this, or you know, you're interested in how Lindsay did it, go ahead and check out this blog post so that you can see exactly what she did. Reza Rad's got a blog post looking at, if you've got a shared table that you're reusing in a lot of reports, take a look at Dataflows as a way to disseminate that table. One of the examples Reza uses is a date table. So if you're reusing a date table in a bunch of different reports, don't copy that data all over the place and potentially, you know, have inaccuracies in that data. Centralize it in something like Dataflows that you can then reuse. And whenever you refresh, everyone's refreshing that same date table. I love the example of using Dataflows to maintain that consistency of data, especially when you don't have a main data warehouse in your organization. But I'm curious, like, what you think. Leave that down in the comments below and let me know, is this a great use of Dataflows? Also, if you want the links to this item along with links to all the items in this week's roundup, go and check that down in the description below along with some bonus items. So go check it out. Report commenting inside of the Power BI service and the mobile app are now rolling out to your tenant. They should be available by about midweek this week. We've had commenting inside of dashboards, but now we can do it inside of reports. We can do it at the visual level. We can do it at the page level. It's great. We can start communicating with other folks. We can just at mention them and be able to have a conversation about specific things. This is a great way for collaborating on reports and to have that conversation about your data. One thing that's commented in the blog post is about RLS. So the data in the report will still reflect RLS itself, but there is a potential of disclosure of data inside of comments if someone actually types in something. So RLS isn't gonna help with that. So just be aware of it, be mindful, and educate the users in your organization about that. The other thing I thought was awesome was in the next steps item at the bottom of this post, there was a mention of putting together a digest of all those comments and sending them to the author of the report. So that'd be really cool for getting feedback on the given report itself. Very cool feature, excited about this. Stay tuned in your tenant for it to be available. We got an updated on-premises data gateway for May, and one of the big things in this release is just more insights and information about performance monitoring. So within the gateway itself now, you can turn on the additional performance items. It'll create three additional log files, and then there is a report that you can download to visualize that data from those log files. So this will help you with gaining more insights about what's going on with the gateway, how it's performing, and maybe how you can go about improving that performance. As always, be sure you update to the latest gateway so that you're just up to date. Everything runs as best as it can with all the updates that are coming up, and you've got the latest mashup engine. So update your gateway, check the blog post down in the description below. We got a feature summary blog post for the Power BI service and mobile app for April. And man, April was a crazy month. If you weren't paying attention, a lot of things went generally available or GA, meaning they are now out of preview. This included Dataflows, the new home area. Also, the new workspace experience went GA as well. So very exciting. Lots of cool things happened. Tons of updates for paginated reports inside of premium. Man, it was a busy month. So if you're not familiar with all the updates that occurred in April, check out this blog post. Go read up on all the things that are there. Do you want to know a secret? I'll tell you a secret. The way that I stay up to date on everything that's happening in Power BI, I read these blog posts. I check out the announcements. I look at what actually came out. Take 15, 30 minutes of your time every week and just go through those blog posts and read up on what's actually happened. You'd be amazed on how well you can keep up with what's going on. All right, I want to pass this off to you. What was your favorite item this last week? Maybe it was something I mentioned, maybe it was something I didn't. I don't know, let me know down in the comments below. I'd love to hear it. If you like this video, be sure to hit that big thumbs up button, smash it if you so desire. If it's your first time here, hit that subscribe button. And as always, from both Patrick and myself, thanks so much for watching. Keep being awesome, and we'll see you in the next video.